I'm here at the nerve centre of the Voice of Ireland. These are the arteries and veins flowing through the whole show. We can see here that there's some red, some black, each of them representing a different contestant.
Get out of there. Get out of there.
I'm just going to just... Give me a second. Just give me a second. It's the first week of the battles, and we all know what that means.
Yeah,
it's one-on-one and there's steals, but the important thing is I'll be backstage interviewing people.
Cool. Okay. So I just turned that off, sorry.
I'm not really good with interviews at all.
All right, okay. Me neither. Can you pierce my ears? No, sorry.
Sure.
I've been told to stop asking you weird questions.
Who's the worst percentage you've ever met?
Alok.
We all know. Aww. V-News. On The Voice of Ireland this week, Kira swallows the Blarney Stone.
Why can't I stop talking?
With only a few weeks to go till the live's own has a word with himself.
Well, I'm glad you're a man of confidence. Confidence is definitely what you need for the live show.
That was a great performance.
Jessica talks about hitting the accelerator just before the go light in Mario Kart.
It would be a major boost for me.
Rachel unveils her new directory inquiry service to rival 11850.
I'm waiting.
Catherine steals my best chat-up technique.
Woo! Ladies!
Una displays her new range of face laminators.
Their faces went like...
I ask Prezi to take me to the gym.
Absolutely not.
And now, over to David.
Thank you very much, David. Now just a quick word from the guys. Carl?
Incredible.
Nick?
Sweet.
I'm sorry, Carl, cut you out there. Back to you, David.
Thanks, David! While Stephanie and Matthias kicked things off with some James Bond and a steal, it was Alison and Jessica who really got the coaches going.
Sour? What does that mean?
Sour, but do you like sweet and sour chicken? Does anyone here like sweet and sour chicken?
What?
Do you now? That's a question. That's
I
a
do.
Good
I
question.
That is not a good question. And now I'm starving. Rachel decided to go with Alison, and backstage I decided to take a new approach to starting interviews. Boo! Most people struggle to put words on the battle's experience.
If you could describe the battles in like one sentence.
Ain't no mountain high enough.
That was cliche.
I don't really get that, but I like it.
Yeah, I still don't get it.
So what did Alison think?
Something that I don't really remember, but I'll probably never forget.
Wow, the last time I heard someone speak that eloquently, it was because...
There was moments in the song that were good, but there was moments that were absolutely brilliant.
Hey, Jenny. Things took an unfortunate turn for Kira when Una buzzed for a steal, but the time was up. Nick, however, was far luckier and goes to Team Rachel. But it was such a weird experience for them that Carl struggles to describe it.
It's like if you were to raise... a baby pig, you know, and it comes to a point where you have to make it into bacon.
It's like, what?
No, you grow, you know, fond of it, very fond of it, and then you have to go out there and
murder
it. Destroy it.
So, Nick, Alison, Carl, Jasmine, Michael, Stephanie, Matthias, Kirstie, and Emmy are the first contestants through to the live shows. Or as the grand return of the Voice of Ireland in 5 seconds shows.
Matthias.
Emmy. Michael.
Alison.
Jasmine.
Kirstie.
Carl.
Panic.
Good to have it back. Add me on Instagram and Snapchat, but not my private one because there are things on there. Tweet me and the show at RTE The Voice and facebook.com/The Voice of Ireland. And subscribe to the channel. There's rags of you here already. Just click it. Go on. It's only 3 weeks until the live knockouts. He did such a good job earlier. I think Carl should try sum them up succinctly.
Brutal. There's another sound, another sound of your heart.